Have you seen the old man in the closed down market, kicking up the paper with his worn out shoes? In his eyes you see no pride, and held loosely at his side, yesterday's paper telling yesterday's news. So how can you tell me you're lonely, and say for you that the sun don't shine? Let me take you by the hand and lead you through the streets of London, show you something to make you change your mind.
Again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away.
Oh, May 1967, Yehuda was on leave from the army and went to visit all his parents. When he arrived, they told him to go immediately to the Al-Hadifs. And there he was told that his father had died and that they had a ticket for him to fly to London. So Yehuda flew to England and arrived in time for the funeral and stayed after the Shiva. It was now June and the tension in Israel was heightening. There was no transportation back to Israel, so Yehuda volunteered to work in the Jewish Agency, interviewing volunteers to help in Israel while the country was being mobilized for what became the Six-Day War. Into the second day of the war, Oded Modan, later of Modan Books, etc., phoned Yehuda at work and told him that he had bought a car for someone and was going to drive to Venice to meet a Tzim boat to take them to Israel. "Does Yehuda want to come?" he asked. They traveled in a two-seater sports car. They were three, but were cheered along their route. They had stickers on the car saying, "Israel's borders are everyone's borders," in several languages. Yehuda went to work at Keter Books on the Encyclopedia Judaica, which was the first electronically produced publication of its kind. Here he learned to touch type. In 1968, while still working at Keter, he did the course for tour guides, organized by the Ministry of Tourism. He decided to try to be a guide for a year or two. 48 years later, he retired. His guiding experience has been diverse. He has guided on ships and boats, in helicopters and in planes. Yehuda has guided guests of the Israeli Ministry of Tourism and the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, such as travel agents and journalists. He was also a guide for the army when he did his army reserves for a while, and also volunteered in the Jerusalem Tourist Police Force. Amongst those Yehuda has guided have been several international famous celebrities, such as personal guests of Frank Sinatra, the Manhattan Transfer, Frankie Howard, Judy Collins, Pastor Robert A. Schuller, and the former Prime Minister of Norway, Gro Harlem Brundtland, before she was the Prime Minister, and Ord Wingate's son, who was the guest of the Ministry of Tourism. But most of his guiding has been with tourists and pilgrims, both with groups and small private parties.
ברחוב הנביאים 64 גרה במשך 60 שנה אחת הדמויות הירושלמיות המופלאות, רופאת הילדים דוקטור הלנה קגן. ותיקי העיר יודעים, רחוב הנביאים הוא ירושלים, וירושלים היא רחוב הנביאים. כל בית ובית ברחוב הזה הוא אוצר בלום של תולדות העיר. המחדשים שבקרב פרנסי העיר סבורים שטוב יהיה להפוך את הרחוב לאוטוסטרדה בת שישה נתיבים ובניינים רבי קומות. העניין טרם הוכרע, אבל אם יאושר, יהיה רחוב הנביאים אחד הרחובות הנפלאים לאורק תנועה ראשי, בלי עבר, בלי זיכרונות. אולי אז יעלה הקורט גם על הבית הזה הנחבא מעט בתוך חצר רחבת ידיים. והלא, גם אם ייקחו ממנו את גינתו בלבד, יעלם חלק מירושלים שהייתה. בשנת 1919 באה לגור כאן רופאה צעירה עם אמא. השתיים הגיעו מתשכנט שברוסיה. הלנה קגן, בת למשפחה ציונית, נשלחה לברן שבשוויץ ללמוד נגינה בפסנתר. שם החליטה שעתידה יהיה ברפואה ולא בפסנתר. כשסיימה את לימודיה, קיימה את צוואת אביה ובאה לארץ. היא באה לכאן לעבוד, לשנות דברים, לתת מעצמה ומכישרונה לעיר. לעולם לא לשאול מה העיר נותנת בתמורה.
בשבילי ירושלים היא זכות, אמרה דוקטור קאגן. אנשים באים הנה בשביל למות. אני באתי כדי לעבוד.
לא מיד התירו לה הטורקים לעבוד בעיר. תחילה הייתה אחות בבית החולים העירוני. ורק בפרוץ מלחמת העולם הראשונה, כאשר שרר מחסור ברופאים, קיבלה הלנה קאגן את הרישיון הראשון שניתן לאישה בממלכה העות'מאנית לעסוק ברפואה. אנשי הכנסייה הרוסית שהיו בין מטופליה נתנו לה בסחירות את הבית שברחוב הנביאים. בית מוזנח, חסר רצפה, חסר חלונות, חסר דלתות. הבית נבנה במחצית המאה שעברה בידי צייר אנגלי, ויליאם הולמן הנט. הנט נמנה עם מייסדי האסכולה הפרה-רפאלית שדגלה בנאמנות לטבע. הוא בא לארץ כדי לצייר ציורי תנ"ך וציורים מחיי ישו במקום התרחשותם. במכתביו לבנו כתב וצייר: אבא רוכש דירה בירושלים. כל מה שהיה שייך לחיי התרבות בירושלים עבר בבית הזה. כאן התארחו רבים מאנשי הרוח בירושלים: חיים ויצמן, ארתור פין, הנריאטה סולד, זאב ז'בוטינסקי, בוריס שץ ומוסיקאים ידועי שם.
Youth leaders from abroad. On Face to Face, reporter Naomi Segal spoke with alumna Yehuda Guy, a Jerusalem tour guide, about the program and the special reunion activities that have been planned.
The program itself is a year program, around a year, actually divided a year into two, or it used to be in two parts. One was the Northern Hemisphere, one was the Southern Hemisphere, where the Northern Hemisphere would start in the summer and end in June, July the following year, and the other program for the South Americans and Australians would be the other half of the year. Half of the year was studying in Jerusalem, and the other half would be in kibbutzim or moshavim throughout the country.
Now, can you tell us about the year that you participated in the program and the youth it brought together?
Our year was 1959 to 1960. Participants were from France, North Africa, that is say French-speaking, and English-speaking from North America, that is say United States and Canada, England, Holland. We had one boy that just received Pas Yisrael for my Machzor, for my year.
And this was?
Manuel Tov, for research into the Bible. He was the first person who received the prize, actually, on that evening of Yom HaTzmaut.
And you came from all over the world?
We came all from the Northern Hemisphere. My year was from the Northern Hemisphere. But one person came from Australia. By accident. The other Southern Hemisphere would start 6 months after we had started.
And what did you do during that year?
And during that year, we were youth leaders, so we went home, and today, many of the, the Jewish leaders of the world are former people who went to this institution. We studied, youth instruction, we studied music, we studied dancing, we studied Hebrew, of course, the geography of Israel, musical expression, psychology, a lot of things, just the things that come to mind at the moment.
And what was Israel like in that time?
And Israel was without the other half of Jerusalem. We had no Wailing Wall. Eastern side of Jerusalem was very limited. Recently, for our 50th anniversary, people have been sending photographs, and I have photographs of us coming down Mitzvah without a path, just climbing down the rocks. Because there was no... we walked, actually, from near Be'er Sheva to Matzada, and then we walked from Matzada to... But that was after, actually, the Machon. That was... We did that from the kibbutz. But the facilities then, we would travel in trucks, a bit like army trucks, safari trucks, as they call them in the army. Open-sided trucks, four rows of seating on benches, and we would travel the country that way. And the most exciting thing that everybody remembers back 50 years is always the tiulim, the excursions we used to take to about a half a dozen, I reckon, at least a half a dozen during the few months that we were in Jerusalem.
Now, of the participants in the program with you, did most return to their countries? Did many make aliyah? You obviously are in Jerusalem.
I'm in Jerusalem. There's others. I reckon about 40% actually live in Israel. Out of 100, we were a total of, I think, 98 or 99 people. About 40% live in Israel. Quite a few still live on kibbutz. Someone lives in Be'er Sheva and is a professor, or just retired professor from Soroka. Some live in Gush Etzion, in Kibbutz Sa'ad, in Mishmar HaNegev, in Sde Boker, in Tel Aviv, of course, and in the north, in Galilee, in Kibbutz Lavi, in various places in the north.
Now, have you stayed in touch over the years?
And some of us have kept in touch with some of us, but we made a big effort a few years ago and had a week tour, of which about 30 people participated in 2006, and we decided that we would do it again as a group in the year on the 50th anniversary, which is this year. We're getting together from May the 9th, Motzei Shabbat, through to the 15th of May. We'll be touring the country like old times, from the north to as far as they book here.
And what are some of the special plans for this week?
One certainly special thing is to make contact with one of our musical teachers, Tzvi Ben Porat, who was a conductor and who wrote music. And everybody remembers his songs, and I know that some people out of my year are still teaching his songs in choirs and children's classes. So that we plan to sing a serenade below his balcony. He's not very well these days. He's over 80. And although he cannot come to us, we are going to sing to him a serenade of his own songs on Sunday morning.
Yehuda Guy, Secretary of the Machon Alumni Association.